Assalamu alaikum guys and welcome to my new YouTube channel Biology Articles and MCQs. Today we are going to start excretion in earth worm. Previously we have studied in excretion in planaria. If you have not studied it yet, I will give the link in the description box. You can study that topic there. Before studying the excretion, well, first of all we want to know that what is earthworm. Earthworm is an organism that belongs to phylum Annelida. And its body is consisting of many segments. The property of these segments in the body of the earthworm is that each segment contains two excretory systems that are helping in the excretion in the body of earthworm. The main excretory system that is helping in the excretion in earthworm is called metanephridia. You have previously studied that in the planaria there were the excretory system that is called protonephridia, but in this earthworm the system is called metanephridia, and there are two metanephridia present in each segment of the earthworm. Here you can see that there is an earthworm and the three segments are shown: the first segment, second segment, and the third segment. These tube-like structures that are present here are called metanephridia. Each segment is containing two metanephridia. First of all, count that first metanephridia is starting from this point and ending at this point. And the second metanephridia starting at this point means they are called that two metanephridia because the half portion of first metanephridia is present in that specific segment, and the means this is the first metanephridia and this is the second metanephridia. The half portion of the second metanephridia is present in this second segment, so we call that there are two metanephridia present in each segment of the earthworm. The excretion starts from this point and that is called a nephrostome. You can see that a nephrostome is surrounding by a tuft of cilia, and these cilia were also present in the planaria in their frame cell, and the same function is performing. The cilia is performing same function in both organisms, either in the planaria or either in the earthworm. These cilia will beat, and the water along with the metabolic waste will enter into the this tube through a opening that is called nephrostome. Here is this is an opening that is called nephrostome. Moving, let us consider that there is metabolic waste present here in the fluid-like portion that is xylem. This xylem, all the metabolic waste is suspended in xylem. The metabolic waste will enter through nephrostome, and nephrostome is the first opening through which the metabolic waste along with the water will enter into the metanephridia, that is simply a tube-like structure that is helping in excretion. Moving from the nephrostome, the water along with the metabolic waste will move into this portion, and this portion is called collecting duct here. And here the collecting duct is also surrounded with a network of capillaries. And this network of capillaries will perform the same function that we have previously studied in the kidney of human being. Capillaries were surrounding the loop of Henle, and this will helping in the reabsorption of salt and excess amount of water. So as the capillaries in the earthworm will perform the same function, means here the water is moving through this collecting duct. These capillaries will reabsorb the excess amount of water or excess amount of salt that the body still needs, and it will enter into the blood. Now the remaining the waste product is present in the collecting tubule or collecting duct. From the collecting duct, moving from the collecting duct, the metabolic waste then enter into a portion that is called bladder. The bladder will help in the storage of that excretory substances for some time, and after storage for some time, that bladder will empty into an opening that is called nephridiopore. Here is the opening that is called nephridiopore. The urine, or simply the excess amount of water, will move out from the body of the earthworm by a small opening that is nephridiopore. So in this way, the excess amount of water is entering into the metanephridia through an opening that is called nephrostome, and then it is moving towards the collecting duct. From collecting duct, it is moving towards the bladder, and from bladder it is emptying it is moving out from the body by the help of small pore, that is nephridiopore. So there are four main parts of the metanephridia, or simply the excretory tubule of earthworm. The first one is nephrostome, the second one is collecting tubule, the third one is bladder, and the fourth one is nephridiopore. In this way, all the excretory system run in the body of earthworm. Next, we have to concern that either the earthworms are monotelic, uricotelic, or ureotelic, means either they are excreting waste products in the form of ammonia or urea or uric acid. Earthworms are the animals that have ability to live both in the amount of water or on the land. So depending upon their location, they will excrete either ammonia or urea. So the earthworms can be either monotelic or ureotelic organisms. If they are present in the water, then they will excrete ammonia, because they have excess amount of water to excrete the nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia. As we have previously studied that to excrete ammonia, there is need of excess amount of water. So the 1 gram of ammonia needs 500 ml of water to excrete its nitrogen. So if the earthworm is present in water, it has ability to excrete its nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia. But if it is present on land, it will excrete its nitrogenous waste in the form of urea, because now they don't have an excess amount of water. And remember this thing, that 50 ml of water is a need to remove 1 gram of urea from the body. In case of ammonia, there was 500 ml water for 1 gram of ammonia removal. But in case of urea, there is only 50 ml of water for the removal of 1 gram of ammonia. Because there is a less need of water, so if the earthworm is present on land, it will excrete its nitrogenous waste in the form of urea. And urea always have 2 nitrogen in its structure. So in case of living on land, they will be ureotelic, and in case of living on water, they will be monotelic. I hope you understand all the things about the excretory system of the earthworm, and all about the metanephridia. If you like this video, share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.